first step is just connecting the rope to this hook I put right here on the back of my chair. Just the eye bolt connected to the axle. Similar to the other minivans. Pretty level transfer. Use the chair to support my weight. Then I just scoot forward just enough to give the ramp and the chair coming back on the ramp a little bit more room. Lock the brake. Get the chair. Get the chair out of the way of the ramp. Took some experimentation on how to get all the positioning right, but once I figured it out, very easy. So the ramp, it's pretty light. It's just made out of 3/4 inch plywood, so I can lower it, and then I just move the chair and position it so it can go up the ramp. So then I use the rope to sort of guide it. It takes a little bit. Okay, so there, and I'm holding tension on it so it's up against the ramp. Let the winch do all the work. And pull it up to the point where when I get out of the vehicle, I want the chair to come down to this level. So that's how far I'm going to pull it in. And then it's pretty light at this point. Just shove it back in the rest of the way. Flip up the ramp. I used to have a rope system to close the door, but that was a little tricky. So just put a strap on the existing door handle, only had to drill one hole. Got this little walking stick with a hook on it. Pull the door, helps it unlatch so it can close. Then I just close the door the rest of the way. Slide my seat back the rest of the way so I have room to get my legs under the hand controls. Spin, go in. And then closing the door, I put this rope and carabiner on the handle, makes it a little easier to reach. First step, slide the seat back, straighten legs. As you go under the hand controls, the Mazda 5 is not quite as roomy as a regular minivan, but I'm a pretty average height guy. About 5'10". There's enough room. If I was a lot taller, I'd probably look for other vehicles. But just get the door unlatched. And shove it open. I can usually get it to latch all the way, but I'll show you what I do in case I can't open it all the way. Let's say it only opens that far. That same stick I used for closing the door, I just keep on my door here. Use that really easy. And I can shove the door open and then it latches. And then I start opening the 5. Doesn't take much effort to latch it. So just lower the ramp. And remember how far I pulled the chair in. Now I know that when I let it out, it's going to stop right where I need it to. Let it down. Wait until the footrest load hits. Still hooked up to the rope, so I have to worry about moving it. And I use the door to support my weight and hook this handle, tip the chair, get it closer, get it out of the way. To do my maneuvering, I need the rope at a certain distance. So I have a marker on the rope to let me know how far to go. Flip up the ramp. Make sure my seat's back all the way for the transfer. Move the chair back to where I need to. Lock the brakes for my transfer. A little more stable. And then it's a nice easy slide over. Some people like to use a transfer board or a speedy-lift. A little board that flips out, but the transfer's easy. Unhook the carabiner, easy. Over. Close the driver's door. And the sliding door unlatches real easy with this handle and then grip. And that's it.